Hello. Kamusta ka na? Ano, kamusta naman ang buhay? I hope everything's fine. I hope that you're eating well. Kamusta naman yung tulog mo? Kamusta naman ang tahanan nyo? Kamusta na yung mga magulang mo? Yung mga kapatid mo? Nakikipag-usap ka pa rin ba sa kanila? May communication ka pa sa kanila? Kamusta naman ang lugar nyo? Marami bang case dyan ng COVID-19? Paano ka ngayon nakaka-cope ngayon? Nakakalabas ka pa rin mo ng bahay? Paano naman yung finances mo? Enough ba yung pera nyo ngayon para makakain kayo sa araw-araw? Na may pambayad pa ba kayo ng bills nyo? Kamusta naman yung trabaho? Nakakapasok ka pa rin ba sa trabaho nyo? Kamusta naman yung puso mo? Ano yung nararamdaman mo ngayon? Ilang araw pa before pa tayo pumunta sa general community quarantine? Paano ka nakaka-cope up ngayon? Malungkot ka ba ngayon? May nakakausap ka ba tungkol sa mga nararamdaman mo? Mayroon bang kumakamusta sa'yo sa mga oras na nalulungkot ka or may mga oras na hindi mo na alam gagawin mo? So, this is are just mere questions that people should talk about, especially in this enhanced community quarantine. Sometimes we are so caught up with the things na we don't have, especially may mga times na syempre talaga may hirapan na tayo mag-isip na maayos because of this pandemic. So far with all the news, the updates na naririnig natin sa balita, sa social media, it seems like there's no moving forward na mangyayari because of this slow progress na ginagawa ng gobyerno, ng tao, in terms of how they cope up with this COVID-19 pandemic. More than just the political and the financial factors that comes with this pandemic, I believe one of the major things that we really have to discuss also is the mental health issues that comes with it. Kasi more than just the finances, the cure for this COVID-19, mental health issue is one of the biggest factors as well when we talk about moving forward from this pandemic. So for the person, from the personal aspect, it's really hard to really talk about mental health kasi right now we are under this hirap sabihin ito. Now we are between two major problems, between karapatang mabuhay and karapatang gumawa ng buhay. So we are in this scenario wherein bakit ka ba iisipin yung mental health ko? Dapat nga pinoproblema ko kung may kakainin pa ba ako sa susunod na araw . Or bakit ko ba ako problemahin yung sarili kong mga problema sa emotions ko kung so far ang problema naman ngayon is paano nga ba tayo mabubuhay despite of this virus? So the reason why we have to talk about mental health issues kasi there are a lot of people out there na nakikita natin behind the scenes na hindi natin alam na more than just the will to survive is the will also to really cope up with what's going on with the in their environment. There are some areas also in terms of mental health that keeps us moving every day kasi ngayon na nasa loob lang tayo ng bahay. Even yung mga tao nagtatrabaho, they also have a hard time also cope up with this new normal. Na syempre, there's a lot of uncertainties, there's a lot of issues going on. We don't know kung ano yung mangyayari with terms of our future and so forth. So maraming factors when it comes to mental health that we should also talk about. Almost 3 months of this pandemic, there are moments na even though I am so productive with what I do, I'm so willing to learn about new things, I'm willing to do some things that will make me productive. May mga times na it's hard for me to wake up in the morning. May mga moments din na nahihirapan din akong gumalaw because of a lot of thoughts coming in my head. And as an overthinker, marami din pala akong mga things and issues in my insecurities about myself na most people don't know. Wala akong masyado nakakausap, wala akong some people na kumakamusta sa akin. And for the past few days and also, I've noticed na how silent my social media is. naramdaman ko how cold it is also in terms of communication, na nahihirapan akong kumausap sa tao. Sometimes, siguro, because they are busy too, they have also things to talk about or things na iniisip din. That's why it's hard for me to really go on. Kasi, paano ka ba makakamove on kung wala kanina mo nakakausap? It's so sad. That's why it's really, for me, it's really hard to really talk about also these kinds of things. Kasi, there are also stigma, there's also taboo about talking about your anxiousness, about yung mga things that you think about, yung mga bagay na gumugulo sa'yo. Kasi, mental health is an inward battle within ourselves eh. Hindi siya basta-basta para lang prescription meds na bigyan ka lang ng meds is gagaling ka na. It's more than that. Mental health is all about human interaction. It's about healing the wounds from the past. It's about making yourself whole again from the pain that you had before. And for me, I'm in a season right now wherein I'm still healing, I'm still coping, and I'm still making my best effort to move forward and to grow in maturity and to really just be happy and just be cool about myself. Because of this enhanced community quarantine, I believe that more and more people will suffer from mental health issues, including anxiety and depression. And somehow kasi because of what's going on with social media, I believe there's a lot of people na rin nag-open na in terms of their anxiety about what they're going through. Maraming taong hindi pa rin nakakaintindi na ano nga ba ibig sabihin ng having someone with depression or being someone who have clinical anxiety. That's why one of the things that we have to cultivate in terms of how we cope up is to have connections as well. We have to make sure that we have to connect with the right people, talk about things na naramdaman natin to someone that we can trust on. I'm so grateful na kahit man lang isa, tatlo man lang sa mga kaibigan ko really care about me and really PM me talaga. Nakausap nila ako by call, by text. Kinakamusta nila ako, kung kamusta na nila, kamusta na ako sa mga nararamdaman ko, kamusta na how I cope up with these things. And it's really important for me to really talk about those things because they're allowing me to do so. So, having someone that you can talk to and you can trust is very important in this pandemic if you want to cope up longer. Hindi pwede na mag-isa lang tayong nag-move forward or mag-isa lang tayong nagbabattle with this anxiety that we have in this quarantine. So, for me, I'm so grateful with the friends that I have. Kahit man lang, tatlo man lang sila or kahit isa man lang sa kanila kumakamusta sa akin constantly, grateful na ako dun. Kasi more than just the numbers of friends that you can have, ano mo ba yung maraming kaibigan kung wala naman silang pakialam sa'yo? So, for me, in this quarantine, I realized na it's enough for me to have even tatlo man lang or few people na kakausap sa akin. For me to know that I am cared enough, that I am loved also. So, the best lesson I learned so far is yung tipong pag-aalaga sa sarili mo. Self-care is not selfish at all. Hindi ko pwedeng i-neglect yung sarili ko for others' sake as well. Because at the end of the day, no matter how you give, no matter how you lend to someone, or no matter how you pour yourself to people, pag ikaw na ubos na, ano pa may bibigay mo sa sarili mo? So, dun ko na-realize na throughout all the things that I've done, may marami pala akong issues in terms of boundaries, in terms of trust as well, na I tend to trust more to so much mga ganong bagay. So, because of that, marami din mga nako-compromise as well. So, knowing your self-worth is the best thing that you can do to yourself during this quarantine. I believe it's for all of us. Hindi lang para sa akin to. Kasi somehow, because of the social media, because of what the social media is telling us, Now we should be like this, we should have this, we should buy those stuff like that. Nakakalimutan na natin yung self-worth natin eh. Na lahat ng yun naka-anchor na sa mga bagay na yun, which is wrong. So, we have to be confident as well with ourselves na we are more than just what we buy. We are more than just the our career or more than just yun sa mga relationship natin. Na ngayon pa lang natututunan na natin how to be secure with ourselves and how we cope up with the issues that we have. And so far, dun pa lang natututunan ko pa lang little by little na I should not sell myself short. I should not compromise to the things that no longer serve me. Na so far, kailangan magkaroon na ako ng boundaries eh. Kailangan ko na magkaroon ng limitations as well na hindi all the time ibibigay ko lahat. Na all the time, kailangan kong mag-compromise para lang people to really like me or para magkaroon lang ng validation na I am worthy enough na kausapin, I'm worthy enough to be loved, na hindi ako difficult mahalin. So, valuing yourself is one of the things that you can give to yourself today. Ako, I'm learning from it and so far, it's better to see ourselves beautiful than thinking or asking for people pa to really validate that. Ngayon pa lang, you have to really be confident enough to say to yourself that you are more than enough, that you are worthy, that you are loved, that you are capable of doing the right, doing good things in this world. And so far, one of the things that I really learned how to cope with this quarantine is to really know that it's okay not to be okay sometimes. Na hindi every time gigising ako, it will be a beautiful day or sometimes it will be an awesome day. Na everyday blessings will come. Kasi at the end of it all, hindi naman basihan ng magandang buhay ang blessings eh. Hindi lang naman yun ang basihan ng how beautiful our life can be. Sometimes a little bit of storm, a little bit of sadness, konting iyak, konting frustration, konting anger can give so much beauty also in our lives. So that's why I'm here outside. Nandito ako sa labas ng building namin kasi right now this is the time na I feel I'm more vulnerable to talk. I'm more vulnerable to speak my mind. Being true to your emotions, being true to yourself is better than just pretending na everything's all okay. Especially in this enhanced community quarantine, you have to go to this position na we should no longer fake what we feel. We should no longer pretend na magiging okay, but magiging okay lang lahat if we conceal yung mga bad thoughts or bad emotions natin. Lalong-lalo na kung totoo naman nalulungkot ka, totoo naman na naiinis ka, totoo naman na nagagalit ka. So, letting those emotions out can really help you cope up and help you move forward as well with this quarantine. At the end of the day, it's really our choice. We have to make choice for ourselves to see kung ano nga ba yung best for us. We have to know what our limitations are and we have to do whatever it takes to cope. Because not because we have to, but because this life we have is so precious. The mere fact that you're safe inside your house at wala kang COVID-19, it's already a blessing. So for now, the best thing that you can do to really cope up with this quarantine or what's going on with your mental health is to really be kind to yourself. It's enough that you care enough for yourself na you don't blame yourself, you don't condemn yourself, you don't put yourself to the position na you're already bringing yourself down because of the things that you don't understand, the things that you cannot control. So, give yourself a break. If you know someone na kailangan ng makakausap, kailangan ng help in terms of their mental health issues, be the one to become a lending hand to them. Talk to them, reach them out, text them, PM them, tell them what you feel and let them be open. Kasi at the end of the day, kung hindi rin tayo magiging open enough to receive those people na tingin lang natin sa kanila is toxic, hindi natin sila matutulungan at all. also the time probably na if you think na this is too much for you to handle, don't be afraid to seek professional help. Na I will give the number of the National Center for Mental Health that you can call so that you can have the help that you need as well. Kasi kung mahihiya lang tayo or will be afraid from the judgment of people kasi pumunta tayo sa mental institute, wala mangyayari sa atin. It's better that we took care of ourselves more than think what people will say against us. So guys, it's just a matter of how you strengthen your faith, strengthen yourself, and let's cope this quarantine together. I'm in the middle of still coping on, and it's not really easy to really wake up in the morning thinking na makaya ka to. May times na hindi, may times na oo. Pero it's just a matter of how we finish the race. So guys, it's good. It's good not to be okay. It's good na may mga dark moments, may times na hindi okay ang buhay. As long as may time pa tayong lumaban, as long as lumalaban pa rin tayo, we can still move forward and we can heal as one. Not just with COVID-19, but also with our mental health situation as well. So guys, take care of your mental health, take care of yourself, and give yourself love so that you can also give love to others. Bye!